Hi, I'm Gary. The Python programming language can be immensely useful for business analysts, data analysts, researchers, and so on. The problem is, if you're not used to programming languages, it can be difficult to know where to get started. So I'll show you, hopefully, a quick and simple way to get started with using Python for your data analysis. What we're going to do is we're going to install Anaconda, and then I'll show you how we use it in a very simple way. Anaconda makes working with Python very simple. What I'm going to do is I'm going to install Anaconda. I have downloaded it, and you would have noticed I downloaded it from anaconda.com/download. So I'll just double click on it and I'll install Anaconda, just accepting the defaults. Once this screen pops up, we just click Next. I'll agree to that. I'll install it, just accepting the defaults, accept the defaults. The same, accept the defaults. Once the installation is complete, you'll be able to click Next and Next. And once again, in this case, I won't look at the welcome, but I would advise that you do. And I won't do the getting started, but I recommend that you do. We'll click Finish. And that's it. Anaconda is now installed. We're ready to use Python. But how do we actually use it? Okay, so Jupyter or Jupyter Notebooks are an easy way to run our code and to visualize the results. So what I'll do is I'll just search, I'm on Windows, but I'll just look for Jupyter Notebook and I'll just open that. So Python is now installed on my computer, Anaconda is. And I'm going to run the code in something called Jupyter Notebook. And Jupyter Notebook runs in a web browser. So I'll run it in Google Chrome in this case. And I'll just wait for it to load up. And this is what it looks like. When I actually want to run my Python code, I'll just click New. And in this case, I'll click Python. We do have the concept of environments. We can add different environments, but I'll create a separate video for that. But for now, we'll just use the Python 3, which is absolutely fine. So Python 3. When we install Anaconda and with R itself, we get various packages installed. Packages are things we do, software that runs in Python or Python run software that helps us do things. So this is what a Jupyter notebook looks like, and we can run our code in here. We add our code into this field and we click run, and then we can run more code and so on. But just to demonstrate, pandas, if you're into data science or working with data, pandas is often your friend. I know I use it a heck of a lot for data analysis. Pandas is, I guess, the Excel of the Python world. We put things into what's termed a data frame. For all intents and purposes, it's like a spreadsheet, an Excel spreadsheet or CSV spreadsheet, and we can actually bring our data from CSV, Excel, text files, and so on. But we need to install it. So a package, how we install a package is you can just find the package that you want, and you can do a Google search for that, or maybe someone will tell you that you need a certain package. And these packages will tell you how to install it. Like here it says pip install pandas. So I'll just copy that. I'll come to my Jupyter notebook. I'll just paste it in there. You'll notice pip install pandas. And what this is going to do is it's going to install the pandas package. In each environment, you only need to install these packages once, and then we can run them. But some packages are automatically installed, some aren't, and it'll take a little bit of sort of working with it to get to understand that. If you're on certain other devices, like a Linux device, you might have to have that in front, but I'm on Windows, pip install pandas, so I'll just run that. And what's going to happen is it's now, and you'll see it in a second, it'll install, download and install various packages. And it says to me here, okay, the requirement was already met. It was already there, so I actually didn't need to, but that's fine. But it says here you might need to restart the kernel. So what I'll do here is I click on kernel, and I'm just going to go restart and clear output. That's very normal once you install a new package, and you only need to do it when you install the package. Now, just to show you that pandas is actually working, is I've got a little bit of a small script I'll use here. So I'm just going to run it. So import pandas as PD. So what we're doing is we downloaded the pandas library. We're just now going to actually import it into Jupyter. So what we're saying here is I'm going to now use pandas. I won't go into the full notation and so on. I'll do that in a separate video. And what I'm doing is I'm just loading up a certain CSV file here. And then I'm just going to look at the head or just to see what it looks like. So I'll click run and we'll just wait for this to run. It shouldn't take too long. And there we go. You can see it actually worked. So it looks a bit all over the place, but you'll get used to it. But honestly, this is the way I've found the simplest to use for the work, whether it's statistics work or whatever data analysis work that I do with Python, is to install Anaconda and use the Jupyter notebook. Please like this video. Please share the video. Please subscribe to my channel.